Okay, there's a guy on the internet asking me on the forum there on Dan Kasky's forum about doing a test with a dime and a couple of nails on an elevated test. He'd seen it on the YouTube, but another guy was doing it using the Deus and I think the CTX. But anyway, I grabbed a couple of 2x4s before I left the house this morning. I'm going to go ahead and set it up. I ain't for sure the exact dimensions and all of how far to have the 2x4s apart. I guess that's about 3.5 inches. And I got a couple of nails I grabbed too. The way the test works is you lay a nail like so on either side of the 2x4. And then we're going to get a dime and put lower in the center so it'll be down, you know, about 1.5 inches. My luck, I ain't got a dime. Hang on. Let's see. Yeah, dude, one fell out. Okay. So we're going to have the dime in here, and we're going to have the nails here. And we're going to sweep, and the dime is going to be 1.5 inches lower than the iron. And we're going to be using the 11x7 coil on the Nocta 4's core. It'll be in 2-tone, 50 sensitivity. Tone break will be at 40. That's the factory set. Now you can't change it. I'll do a quick ground grab. And I'll let you hear the iron. Alright. Put the dime in. I don't know if it'll pass this test or not. I ain't never done this, so let's see. Yeah, it actually. Yeah, it's actually reading the dime. That dime reads about 82 and. I see 82 flash in there, so. So that does pretty good. Better than I expected. Let's see what a nickel does. The one thing that's unique about these Nocta 4's cores is you can't change that tone break. It's set at 40, yet at the same time it's got a tight enough coil and it's got enough bleedy audio that the rejected targets, you'll notice like the nails and stuff, still try to come to the high side just audibly, you know, so you don't have the problem, because that nail's probably only reading about 12. 13, 14 maybe. I don't know exactly where they read. I ain't never paid much attention to them, but on this machine. But what happens is the way the machine's not using a lot of filtration, it lets targets become more poppy. Sort of like the way a 1266 or something like that used to do. Except with when you got these two tones, you got more audio intelligence. So it makes more sense to you. You can pick out a false from an actual hit just by the intelligence of the way it sounds, the roundness of the high tone instead of the quick clip of the high tone. A quick clip high tone, you'll know a false, but a round high tone intermingled with all the iron grunt. That's another thing, the tones roll together too. So when you're in a ton of rolling together iron sounds, that constant barrage of machine gun sound, those little quick clips, you'll know they're Thoughtson of the nails going high, but that smoother, rounder sound intermingled with them rolling nail tones will alert you to a target that needs to be investigated. Okay, I've put a nickel down there, so let's see what the nickel does. That nickel reads about 54, and we're getting about a 55, 56 in there, so. Actually, the nickel's going to read better. Anyway, it's a larger coin. So, that dime. I think in that video, the other person has done, they was using a real, maybe a one real, I ain't for sure, but it's a pretty small coin. You can see that that's probably 3.5 inches, I guess. That 2x4 there is 3.5, so if I turn, it'd be about right. I mean, well, that's right there, let's see. Yeah, I'd say that's 3.5, something like that. All right. And you can see how tight that, that's a tight coil, right? That's a dang good coil. I mean, it's just tight. The way they built it, and it's solid built, too, it's epoxy field. So, it takes a tight coil to get in between nails like that. You can start modifying these tests and turning the nails like this, and you might encounter some other, on the military road. You might encounter problems. So. So you can't do it like that. That's understandable because you're coming across that plane. That gets real hard. But now a nickel might. That's what the test the guy's doing on the internet is biased for the deuce against the CTX. So, let's see what this does. I could, see, that's where the coil starts to shut down when those nails are long ways like that. And actually, if you take the nails like he's got in the video and put them on a sloping like this, and then drop back down to the dime, you're going to see a little different. Watch this. See how much better that dime sounds? That's why you got to watch people when they do videos. See how much harder it is when I do my nails like this, but when I put my nails like this, see how much easier it is? And then when it gets like this, you really got to have a machine. That coil can't do it. And now if I put the small coil on here, we'd probably hit that dime. And that's what I need to do. Let me go ahead and put the small coil on. Let me hit pause for a minute. You know, I got the small coil on here, so let me turn it back on. We'll be on the 50 cents and two-tone. Let me do a ground grab. Let's see what it does on this dime now, on the nails being long ways. See, it tears it up.